This is JB from Not Alliance Over Arkham. This time we are continuing trying out the new starter decks for Winnifred Habbamock and Stella Clark in the Return to the Midnight Masks scenario. Last time we got 4 experience from the gathering scenario. We weren't able to kill the ghoul priest, so the ghoul priest is added to the encounter deck for this scenario. We also weren't able to burn down the house, so the house is still standing and we're starting at your house location. And we added Little Chandler to the Stella Clark deck, as Stella is the lead investigator for this campaign run. I am using the pre-built starter decks for both Wini and Stella, but with the 4 XP, let's look what upgrades we put into the decks. So let's start with Winifred. So I added adaptable to the deck to be able to switch some of the less good cards into other cards. I ended up using adaptable to change the 2 opportunist cards to 2 quick thinking cards. Then with the remaining 3 XP, I added 2 momentum and also 3 copies of the 3 of aces, and that's a total of 4 experience. To make room for those cards, I removed 2 copies of daring maneuver and 2 copies of Cheap Shot and 1 copy of Slip Away. As Wini really likes to boost the skill tests, and her assets are quite pricey with the lockpicks, Mauser and also Lonnie Ritter. And as Wini has streetwise, I thought that I will change the events into skill cards, so they synergize better with the Daredevil. And I have resources over to use for the assets and the streetwise level 0. That's enough of Winnie's deck. Let's see Stella's upgrades next. For Stella, I removed 2 copies of Oops and 2 copies of Dumb Luck, because I don't see those cards being really useful. Instead, I added 1 Plucky. Plucky is a good way to have an intellect and will boost at hand. And also, because Miss Doyle is maybe one of my favorite survival cards, I added Miss Doyle. And to help out lean more towards investigating with Stella, I added 2 copies of Sharp Vision. So other than that, the both Stella and Wini decks are basically the starter decks upgraded with cards from all of the other cycles, so I am not sticking with only the cards that come in the investigator starter decks. But that's enough of the decks. Let's go back to the scenario. We are starting at your house, and because we are playing a 2-player game, there is 1 visible of the devourer in the south side location at the start, so we need to put that guy out of his misery soon enough. Just checking if I forgot to add the doom. So after you spawn visible of devourer, you must either place 1 doom or place 1 of your clues on its location. So I think we need to add the doom there. Okay, we have shuffled and removed 3 from the cultist deck. So we have the new return to versions of the cultists and the old remaining ones shuffled, and then we removed three, so I don't know what cultists we are facing. So I think we just start and see how this goes, and hopefully we can get at least two cultists, or maybe three. I'm not really sure we can manage more than that, but let's see how it goes. So let's get started. I have pre-shuffled all of the decks, so let's start by drawing our opening hand for Wini. We get Nimble, Momentum, Quick Thinking, Daredevil, and Three of Aces, so only skill cards. I think about the Three of Aces, I basically only added them to the deck to have more skill cards. I am not looking for a way to get all three in hand, rather than just have an extra skill card to commit to test so that Wini can trigger her ability. So I think we'll see. I think I'll keep the quick thinking and I'll discard the rest and mulligan four cards. So we get the Streetwise times two, Sneak By, Leather Jacket, and Quick Thinking. So not looking that good for Wini, but hopefully we can draw into some good assets to play soon, so we can deal with all the cultists. Quick shuffle for Winnie's deck, and then let's see what Stella draws. So we get Granny, Orn, Derringer, a Test of Will, we redraw that, Look What I Found, and Sharp Vision. So I think there might be a slight change of plans now, because Stella drew a weapon. I think we'll head to deal with the cultist with Stella. And I think I'll mulligan those two cards, so let's see. We ended up with Granny on either way, and we get Grimm's Fairy Tales. So some horror healing also. Not really keen on the Grimm's Fairy Tales card, but yeah. Well, try it out as it's in the starter deck. Let's shuffle Stella's deck and start playing. So I think I'll start with Stella. First action, I'll play down the Derringer. It has two ammo. It costs three resources, and I'll investigate. I'll use Sharp Vision. Okay, so we are testing 5 versus 2. And it's a 0. So we managed to get both of the clues with the Sharp Vision. A last action, I'll move to the River Town. So next turn we can move to Southside and deal with the cultist. And River Town is a one-shot location with 2 clues. And that's it. So that's Stella. And we'll start with Wini. First action, I'll play down Streetwise. Just put it there. And I think that is everything Wini can do. So we'll move here. And I think I'm investigating for my last action, I'll commit quick thinking. And the other streetwise, so I'm committing two different cards, so I draw one card, I get the lockpicks, nice. I think I'll play that next turn. So, Wini is investigating 5 versus 1. And... let's see... we get a plus 1, so we get one clue. And the quick thinking triggers, so we get an extra action. And we'll spend the action to investigate, and I'll spend 2 resources to boost Winnie's intellect by 2. So we're again investigating 5 versus 1. It's a minus 3, so lucky we boosted the test, and we get the clue. So a decent start with both investigators. We managed to get 4 clues. And let's go to the enemy phase. The disciple doesn't do anything. We go to upkeep. Wini gets Daredevil, and Stella gets a desktop wheel, and both get one resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda, and the threshold is 6. Doom. Stella's encounter card is Hunting Shadow. You must either choose one, spend one clue, or take 2 damage. I'll take the damage because Stella has plenty of health to go around. And Winnie's card is Hunting Night Gaunt. So we get a Hunting Night Gaunt, so I'll place it there. And I think Wini needs to start evading that. But yeah, that's the Mythos phase done. We'll go to the investigation phase. I think I will start with Wini. So, as a first action, I will evade using the sneak by. I'm evading 5 versus 1. And I think that is good enough. I'll get 2 resources. And we are testing. We are 4 up, so we need minus 2 or better. And it's a 0, so we evade easily. So the Night Gaunt is evaded. Second action, I'll play the lockpicks. So the level 0 lockpicks reads action exhaust lockpicks, investigate at your agility value to your skill value for this investigation. If you do not succeed by at least 2, discard lockpicks. So we really need to keep in mind that we want to succeed by 2 or more. And last action, Wini will actually spend the clues to spawn one of the cultists, so we don't end up losing some of the clues. So just draw the top card from here, and we get Jeremiah Pierce. So Jeremiah spawns at your house, otherwise Rivertown. So we get Jeremiah there. So Jeremiah has an action parlay. At Jeremiah Pierce to the victory display, then test willpower 4. Place one doom on the current agenda for each point you fail by. This can cause the current agenda to advance. So I think we will change our plan with Stella. So Stella could go and deal with Jeremiah Pierce, because Stella has a good way to boost willpower at the moment. We'll do that. So first action with Stella, we will move to your house. and Jeremiah engages us, but we will do a parley. I'll commit Grimm's Fairy Tale and a test of will to the test, so we automatically move Jeremiah to the victory display. I'll just place it over here. So one cult is down, and then we test the willpower test. So we're testing 3, 4, 5 versus 4. So we're just looking for not to fail by a lot. And it's an elder sign, and I won't fail it, so I just take the plus 1. So we pass the test and we don't have to add any doom. And the last action is that we will move back to Rivertown, ready to go after the cultist next turn. And that is both investigators done. Enemy phase, nothing happens. Upkeep, the Night Gaunt readies and engages Winnifred. And we go to upkeep, so we draw a card, we get the Mouser for Wini, that's really good, and one resource. And also Stella gets Will to Survive, and one resource. Okay, so that's the end of that turn, let's go to the next turn. We add another Doom. Stella's encounter card is a locked door. There are no clues on any of the locations, so we'll just put the locked door to your house location. Why not? And Winifred's card is Masked Horrors. Each investigator with two or more clues takes two horror. If no horror is dealt by this effect, place one doom on the current agenda. So we place one doom because we don't have any clues. And this can cause the agenda to advance, so that's okay. It's basically a agent evils at this point, but okay, so that's the mythos phase done. We go to investigation phase, so I think we will start with Winifred. So I think I'll just try to evade the Nightborn again. We are evading 5 versus 1, so a minus 2 or better. It's a minus 2, so it doubles, so we just barely succeed, so the Night Gaunt is evaded. Second action, I'll play down the Mouser. It comes into play with 5 ammo. And last action. Let's see here. I think Wini could go up to East Town, so I think we have to split up now, and I think Wini won't go into the graveyard, so let's head up to East Town. It's a two-shroud location with two clues, and while you are at East Town, reduce the cost of each ally asset you play by 2. And that is Winifred's turn done. We go to Stella. So first action, Stella moves down to south side. So that cultist engages us, and Southside is a two-shroud location with 2 clues. And action, search your deck for an ally asset and add it to your hand. Shuffle your deck, limit once per game. So I think Stella will be using that action to search for Miss Doyle. second action, we will spend one ammo and shoot the cultist. We are shooting 5 versus 3. So, I won't commit anything to this test, just test it. And it's a tablet, and tablet is a minus 3. If you fail, place one of your clues on your location. Well, we don't have any clues, we fail. And because we fail, we get ammo back to the derringer. We'll use the extra action we just generated with Stella. We'll shoot again. Again, 5 versus 3. It's a skull, and skull is X is the highest number of doom on a cultist enemy, so minus 1. So we hit, and we defeat the cultist. And last action. I will search for... I think I'll do that next turn, so I'll investigate here 2 versus 2. So we are looking to fail this test so I can play what I found. But let's see how it goes. It's an Elder Sign. So I will use Stella's ability. Elder Sign ability. You may instead choose to automatically fail this skill test to heal 1 damage and 1 horror. So... now I'm not that sure, because if we automatically fail, does it count us as the automatic fail, so we couldn't use the look what I found. I think that means it's an automatic fail, so we can't get it to succeed with the... Or we can't... I think I'll play it that we just take the Elder Sign effect plus 1 and get 1 clue. I'll have to check that interaction later. So that's the investigation phase done. Enemy phase, nothing happens. Upkeep, the night count readies. Mini draws are Daredevil. Gains 1 resource. Stella draws grit your teeth and gains 1 resource, so that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 4 doom of 6. Stella's encounter card for this turn is Hunting Shadow. You must either choose one, spend 1 clue or take 2 damage. I'll take the damage again. Winnifred gets on Wings of Darkness. Test Agility 4. If you fail, take 1 damage and 1 horror, then disengage from each non-Night God enemy. I think I'll commit Daredevil to the test and we'll search for a skill. So, okay. We get anything you can do better, so we're testing 11 versus... Oh yeah, we draw a card. We're testing 11 versus 4. And of course it's the auto fail. Oh no. So we fail, and we'll move here. This engages us, and we'll take 1 damage and 1 horror. Well, that was expected. Highly expected outcome. Okay, so that's the mythos phase done. We'll go to investigation phase. I'll start with Stella. First action, I will search for an ally asset. and I'll pick Miss Doyle. Then I will play Miss Doyle. And we'll shuffle the cats. So let's see which cat we get to help us. And we get Seal, so we fight better with Seal. I would have wanted to get Ogre, but it is what it is. At least now Stella can fight pretty good. And we have a damage and horror, so in the form of Miss Doyle. Then... I think I'm just trying to investigate for my last action. So I'm investigating 2 versus 2. It's a -3, we fail, so we get an extra action and I'll use that to investigate again. 2 versus 2. It's a -3. And we drop the clue. But we fail, and we fail by 1. Actually, we fail by... So it... Yeah, we can't play Look What I Found. If it were a -2, then that would help. Okay, so we'll go to Winnifred. I think we'll try to fight. No, let's just keep evading this guy. So I'm evading, and I'm evading. I think I'll commit. No, we'll evade 5 versus 1, so we need a -2 or better. It's a +1, so we evade. And we'll move back here. And let's use the lockpicks to investigate. I'm not committing anything, so I'm investigating 8 versus 2. It's a -4, so we succeed by 2 or more. We get 1 clue, and we don't lose the lockpicks. And that is the investigation phase. Enemy phase, nothing happens. Upkeep. This guy readies, the lockpicks ready. Winifred gets lucky cigarette case, and Stella gets another grit your teeth. And that is that turn. Oh yeah. Both get 1 resource also. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 5 doom of 6. Stella's encounter card for this turn is Hunting Shadow again. I don't have any clues to spend, so I just take the damage. This is... How can Stella draw all of them? That's just unbelievable. Well, it is what it is. Winifred's card is Disciple of the Devourer. I think so. Farthest empty location. So let's see. I think the farthest is 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So I think it's the St. Mary's Hospital. And we place 1 clue here. So I think Stella needs to go deal with that cultist. So we... Well, it doesn't matter because we're at the witching hour. So we are advancing no matter what next turn. So I think I'll just focus on trying to get some clues and... try to spawn another cultist this turn before we get whatever comes behind that card. So, investigation phase, I'll start with Stella. So, I'm investigating 2 versus 2. It's an auto fail. We get an extra action. I'll investigate. Oh yeah, and we'll play Grit Your Teeth, so we get plus one to each of our skills this turn. So I'm investigating 3 versus 2 now, and it's a minus one, so we pass, and we investigate again. And it's a minus one, so we pass. So we get both of the clues, last action. I think I'll move here next. Oh yeah, this should be unrevealed. Well, it's revealed now. We add two clues, and this guy engages us. So we can heal 3 damage, and I think we'll do that next turn, but first we kill the display of the devourer. Shroud of two clues, yeah. So that's Stella done. We'll go to Winnifred. I will investigate using the lockpicks. Not committing anything to the test, so 8 versus 2. It's a cultist, and it's a minus 2. Place one doom on the nearest cultist enemy. So we place one doom here, it doesn't matter. And we get the clue. Second action, Wini will spend clues from Stella and herself, and will spawn another cultist, and this is the Olma Hill. So it spawns at south side. Parlay, draw the top 3 cards of the encounter deck, then add Alma Hill to the victory display. So we'll just put it here. Okay, so I think Stella will do that also next turn, or the turn after that. But another quite easy cultist to deal with, but we'll see what comes from the agenda deck and how the turn will go. So, last action, I think Winifred will move to downtown. And it's a 4 shroud location with 2 clues. Heal 3 horror, and there's actually 4 clues here. So, that is the investigation phase done. We go to enemy phase, the hunting knight got hunts here. We go to upkeep, we ready the lockpicks, and oh yeah, enemy phase, this guy hits Stella for 1 damage. I'll put it on this Doyle. And yeah, upkeep, so we draw a card, we get another leather jacket and resource, and we get sharp vision for Stella and win 1 resource. So I think Stella could get the clues from St. Mary's also next turn with the sharp vision, but let's see. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, so we hit the doom threshold. Also, these doom get removed. And let's see which baddie we get. So we get the Masked Hunter. Spawn, engage with prey, prey most clues. So I can decide between Stella and Wini, and I'll spawn the Masked Hunter, engage with Winifred, because Wini can better manage the Masked Hunter. I think we'll just give it the old runaround. Yeah, then we have a time is running short, we have a doom threshold of 8. We get encounter cards, Stella gets hunting night count. Okay, so this is not looking that good. We have too many enemies to deal with at the moment, but there's always the chance to resign. So this is engaged with Stella. And false lead. If you have no clues, false lead can search. We have no clues, so we search it and we get on Wings of Darkness. And let's see. I'll commit Daredevil and the Mauser. Oh, let's just commit the Daredevil. So we discard cards until we hit the skill we can commit. So we commit 3 of Aces. And we commit 2 different cards, so we draw a card, we get Lonnie Ritter. I think we could play Lonnie Ritter next turn, maybe. So we are testing 7 versus 4. It's a minus 1. We succeed. And that is the Mythos phase done. Investigation phase. I think we'll resolve Winifred first. So Wini will evade the masked hunter. I think we could try to just... well, the masked hunter has 8 health, so I think Wini can't deal with that, so... I'll just try to evade as first action. I'm evading a 5 versus 2. It's a skull, it's a 0. The mask hunter is evaded. Second action, we'll move to north side. The north side is a 3 shot location with the 4 clues. Spend 5 resources, gain 2 clues from the token pool. As a third action, I think I will investigate here. I'll use the lockpicks. I'm investigating 8 versus 3. It's a 0. So we grab 1 clue from here. And that is Winifred's turn, so we go to Stella. So Stella has 2 enemies. First action. Let's see. So first action, I think I'll try to evade the Night Gaunt. So I'll commit the Will to Survive to the test. I'm testing 5 versus 1, so minus 2 or better. And it's a 0, so we evade the Night Gaunt, this one. Second action, I'll use Zeal to punch the Disciple of the Devourer. So I'm punching 5 versus 3. It's a 0, so we hit. So this guy is defeated. And last action, I think I will investigate. I'm committing Sharp Vision to the test, so I'm investigating 5 versus 2. It's a minus 1. So we pass by 2 or more, we get 2 clues from this location. And that is our turn. Enemy phase. This Night Gaunt hunts here. Enemy upkeep phase. This readies, and engages Stella again. and the lockpick's ready and the seal readies. And we gain one card. We get Pilfer, which is really nice. We can actually clear this location with that next turn. One resource, so we can also play it. And Stella gets Rabbit's Food. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a Doom. Stella's encounter card for this turn is Mask of Umordov. Attach to the nearest cultist enemy and place one Doom on that enemy. There are no cultist enemies in play. Search the encounter deck and discard pile for a cultist enemy. Draw it and attach Mask of Umordov to it. Shuffle the encounter deck. Attached enemy gets plus 2 health. If attacked enemy is non-unique, it gains aloof. So the closest cultist is Alma Hill, so Alma gets plus 2 health, but nothing more. And that's fine, because we're probably heading there and pawling next turn. So, encounter card for Wini is false lead. If you have no clues, false lead can search. If you have one or more clues, test. Willpower 4, intellect 4. For each point you fail, I place one of your clues onto your location. Okay. You have nothing to commit, so I'm not committing the Pilfer. But we can fail it and play Pilfer, then lockpick and move out. I think that's the plan. So we'll just test it. I'm testing 3 versus 4. And it's 0. Oh yeah, we forgot to place. So it's a minus 1 because there's one Doom here. So we fail. We place one of our clues onto the location. That's the Mythos phase done. Let's start the investigation phase. So I think it's more important to play Stella's turn first. So first action, we'll evade. I commit the Rabbit's Foot to the test. I'm evading 5 versus 1, so we need a minus 2 or better. It's a cultist, it's a minus 2. So we place one Doom on the nearest cultist. So this guy gets Doom, but we still evade. And second action, we'll heal 3 damage. Last action, we'll move to the south side. So Alma Hill engages us, but we can take the horror and parlay next turn. So that's Stella done. All according to plan. So we go to Winnifred. So I think I will first pilfer. So we use agility instead of. So it costs 4. We use agility instead of intellect. Then we'll commit Mauser to the test. We are testing 6 versus 3. It's a 0, so we pass, and we'll grab 3 clues from here. Second action, I'll use the lockpicks to investigate 8 versus 3. It's a minus 1, so we don't lose the lockpicks. We grab the clue. Last action, we'll move to Miskatonic University. And it's a 4-strat location with the four clues, search the top six cards of your deck for a tome or spell card and add it to your hand, shuffle your deck. So we know that neither Stella or Wini has any of those, so we are not doing that this game. And that is the investigation phase done. Enemy phase, the Night Gaunt and the Masked Hunter hunt here. The Alma Hill hits Stella for true horror. I'll take one on Miss Doyle and one on Stella. And we go to upkeep. We ready. So this Night Gaunt ready is. Lockpicks ready. We draw a card. We get three of aces. Gain one resource. Stella gets look what I found and one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at four, doom of eight. Stella's encounter card is Crypt Chill. So we are testing 3 versus. I think we can lose the Derringer. I don't see Stella fighting that much anymore. Just running around, chasing leads. I'll just test the 3 versus 4. It's an Elder Sign, so I'll take the plus 1, so we'll succeed. So we don't have to discard anything. And Wini gets Mask of Umurdo. The closest cultist is unfortunately the Mask Hunter. So the Mask Hunter gets plus 2 health and on a doom, and that's the mythos phase done. We go to investigation phase. So I think we'll start with Wini. We'll spend 4 clues as our first action. I will spawn another cultist, and it is Ruth Turner. So spawn St. Mary's Hospital after Ruth Turner is invaded, add her to the victory display. So I'm pretty sure Wini can deal with that. Second action, we'll move there. And last action, we'll I think we'll evade the Night Gaunt this turn. So I'm evading 5 versus 1. So we need a minus 2 or better. It's a minus 2 because there's 2 clues on a cultist enemy. So we pass. So this Night Gaunt is evaded. That's Winnifred done. How many cards do we have? We have not too many. And we go to Stella. First action, I will just parlay. Get rid of this. Oh yeah. First we need to draw the encounter card. So we draw the top 3 cards. The encounter deck. First is Corpse Taker. Spawn for the farthest empty location, so let's check 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I think up here is the farthest, and I'll just use these. So paused at the end of the mythos phase, place 1 doom on the Corpse Taker after the enemy phase. At the end of the enemy phase, Corpse Taker moves once towards River Town or Main Path. If Cops Taker is already at Rio Town on main path, move all Doom from Cops Taker to the current agenda. So we need to try and deal with that. But yeah, that's the first one. Second, Grip Chill. Again, we can just lose the Derringer. Or actually, we could just lose Seal. Yeah, I think that's better. It's a zero, so we fail. We get an extra action. We lose Seal. Then the last counter card. It's an Obscuring Fog, so it doesn't do anything bad. And we add Alma Hill to the victory display. So we have two cultists defeated. Second action. I'll move to River Town. Third action, I'll move to the graveyard. After you enter the graveyard, test will fall 3. If you fail, you must either take 2 horror or move to River Town. There's 4 clues here, so I think we'll clear this for the victory point with Stella and maybe get one more cultist in play. Last action, I will investigate. I'm investigating 2 versus 1, hoping to get the minus 1 or 2 minus 2. It's a cultist. It's a minus 2, place 1 doom on the nearest cultist enemy. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Yeah. I'll just put it here. Oh no, let's put it over here. No, because this guy is getting clues or doom all the time. So we don't have to move, and we fail, and we'll say, look what I found. I'll grab 2 clues from here. And that is Stella's turn done. Enemy phase. These both are here. The root turner hits us for 1 damage. That is fine. And that's the enemy phase done. We go to upkeep. The Night Guard readies, engages Wini. And we draw a card. We get Arrogance, unfortunately. And we gain 1 resource. We draw a card. We get Mysterious Raven. And we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 5 doom of 8. Stella's encounter card is Locked Door. We put it on the location with the most clues, so let's just put it to downtown. And Vinny's is Mask Horrors. Each investigator with 2 or more clues takes 2 horror. So we just take the horror for both. That is all fine at this point. And that's the middle space done. So, I would really like to succeed in this test. So, I think we'll try to evade Rule Turner. I'll spend 2 resources. To go to 7, then I have to commit Arrogance, but I'll commit also 3 of Aces, so I'm still 7 versus 5. So let's see if Wini can do it. It's plus 1, so we managed to evade Root Turner, and Root goes into the victory display, so we have 3 cultists defeated. Second action, I'll evade the Night Gaunt. Oh yeah, the arrogance comes back into my hand. I need a minus one or better because I have to commit arrogance, so I'm evading 4 versus 1. It's a minus one, so minus two, so we evade. Last action. I think we'll move here. Yeah, because then we don't have to deal with three enemies next turn. We only get the Mass Hunter at the other Night Count. We'll go to Stella. Stella's first action is to... I think we'll investigate. Investigating 2 versus 1. So we're hoping to fail again, because we have the other two that I found in hand. We get minus 3 if you fail, place one of your clues to your location. Well, that sucks. We'll fail, we get an extra action. And... we failed by too much. I'll play the Grit Your Teeth. We'll investigate again. 3 versus 1. It's an Elder Sign, so we succeed. I think we'll investigate again. 3 versus 1. Minus 1, we succeed. And last action, we'll just investigate, and I'll actually commit the to what I found. So we're investigating 5 versus 1. It's a minus 2. So we clear the location, and next turn we can try to spawn another cultist somewhere. That's the investigation phase done. We'll go to the enemy phase. So these both hunt here and hit Wini. I think Wini is gonna resign next turn. So we'll take 3 damage in total. And 1 horror from the Night Count. Yeah, Wini can't survive for that long anymore, so... nothing else. Yeah, at the end of the enemy phase, this guy moves. Oh yeah, we should have placed one Doom here at the end of the Mythos phase. Then this guy moves at the end of the enemy phase, once towards River Town, so... move it to East Town. And we have... I think we need to resign with both next turn. Because now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we might doom out quite easily. Actually, we will doom out in 2 turns, so the next turn will be the last. So that's the enemy phase done. Upkeep, we draw a card, we get momentum. And resource, and then we gain live and learn and 1 resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. We are at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 doom of 8. Encounter card for Stella is Ghoul Priest. Okay, so when the Ghoul Priest spawns, spawn it here instead of its normal location. So the Ghoul Priest spawns at our house. Well, that is all fine. And Winnie's card is Obscuring Fog, so no problem. It's really foggy in the south side, but that doesn't matter anymore. Investigation phase. I think I will spend all clues from Stella to spawn another cultist. Maybe we get lucky and get the guy in the graveyard. Okay, that's so lucky. So we get Herman Collins, spawns graveyard, action, choose and discard four cards from your hand, parlay, add Herman Collins to the victory display, so we just got a freebie cultist. So... except we don't have four cards at hand. Well, Wini has. Okay, so... one... Let's count this. Maybe Wini could do something. So if Stella moves here... Action. Actually, Stella could move here and resign. Then Wini needs to get rid of... Wini needs to take 3 damage, which is too much. Oh, I... damn, I don't have enough resources to play the... Arrogance is a problem. I really would have needed 2 resources to play Letter Code. Wini could just get defeated. No. Why don't have a, I have a, I really need a nimble right here to make this work. Oh yeah, at the end of the mythos this guy gets one more doom. So if I draw a card with Stella, I can do the parlay, but then Stella will doom out. I think there's no way to get Herman Collins without dooming out, but... And Wini doesn't have any way to get extra actions this turn, unfortunately. The moment the nimble would have helped us quite a lot this turn. Oh yeah, this is ready also. I think I'll opt to just defeat Herman Collins. It will make the next scenario a bit easier. Then we only have to face 2 cultists. So I'll draw a card. And it's hope, so no weakness that screws us up. And last action, I'll discard 4 cards. Oh yeah, and I'll take 1 damage and 4 for drawing a card. That's all fine. And Herman Collins is added to the victory display. And that's Stella. So we go to Winnifred. I think Winnifred will just resign. Dropping 2 clues here. Doesn't matter. There's no victory point there. And we go to the enemy phase. This guy hunts here. This guy hunts here. This guy moves at the end of the enemy phase here. That is the turn, so we go to upkeep. Stella draws a card. Old Kirin and 1 resource, and that is that turn. So let's go to the next turn and doom out. So we add a doom, and we are way over the threshold, so unfortunately, we get resolution 2. So, in your campaign log, under cultists we interrogated, record the names of each unique cultist enemy to display, and it's Herman Collins, Returner, Alma Hill, and Jeremiah Kears. Cultist who got away is the Mask Hunter and Billy Cooper. In your campaign log, record that it is past midnight, and the ghoul priest is still alive, and we gain victory X for each card in the victory display. So we have 4, 5, 6. So we gain 6 victory points to upgrade our decks. And yeah, that is the return to Midnight Masks with Wini and Stella. This went quite good, except that we doomed out, and that will hurt us in the next one. But on the contrary, we got 4 cultists in this scenario defeated. So it will make the next scenario a bit easier in that regard. So that was that scenario. And next time we'll be playing the Return to the Devourer below. And thanks for watching. Until next time.